Good afternoon. It's truly an honor to be here today, and I really want to start out by commending the Institute of Medicine for convening this roundtable on obesity solutions, and in particular, Lynn Parker and her staff. As Mary said, I'm going to focus on three things. I'm going to describe the activities in early care and education, and I'm going to use the CDC spectrum of opportunity, which represents a range of avenues that states and communities have taken to address obesity, things like licensing and regulations and quality ratings. And then I'm going to look forward on where the gaps are and finally give you my thoughts on an area that needs focus in terms of breakthrough action. So at Nemours, we focused on the area of early care and education now for 10 years. And we recognize that early care and education is the intersection of home, school, or education, and community. And I'm really excited to report that there's really been an exponential growth of activity in the area of early care and education in obesity. And actually, when Bill and Dietz and I first launched Healthy Kids, Healthy Future in 2009, that was the first time that we brought together experts together from early education and from health to work on this problem. And since that time, there's been a huge growth in this area. We've seen the release of the CDC spectrum of opportunities, and that represents a comprehensive set of avenues for states and communities that have successfully used to change early care and education environments. It's right here, and not all opportunities need to be pursued in a state, but certainly doing a number of them helps. I'm not going to go through all of them. I'm just going to go through a few of them by way of example. In the area of licensing and regulations, we've seen many states take on this area and really change healthy eating, physical activity, include those standards in child care licensing. In the area of child and adult food care program, which is the next one, the USDA has made significant investment in things like teen nutrition grants, which has encouraged states to focus in this area. With the area of quality rating and improvement systems, there's really an opportunity here to align the definition of high quality early education with strong healthy eating and physical activity best practices. At the child care level, the facility level, there are now tools that make it as easy as possible for providers to adopt and integrate healthy eating and physical activity into the daily routines. And there's Healthy Habits for Life, which Nemours did with Sesame Street Workshop. There's Color Me Healthy. And also, we've really increased opportunities in terms of access to healthy environments. Nemours has been working with the CDC to expand a collaborative network to really work with child care centers to improve the environments. And so all of this, as kind of summarized in this last chart, that really shows the growth of initiatives in early care and education. It's a chart from last year that CDC put together. And it's just an illustration of the growth of different initiatives, anywhere from the CTG to what's happening with YMCA communities, what's happening with the Early Care and Education Collaborative that I mentioned earlier. There's now also 1305 money from CDC, where every state needs to focus on early care and education, at least focus on it. So there's been a lot of growth in activity. And when we first started working in early care and education in 2004, there was just a handful of states, a couple of states that were focusing on early care and education. And so you can see how much growth there has been in activities in this area. Moving forward, these are the areas where I think there needs to be more focus. One is a focus on sustainability. We know there's a lot of great activity going on and a lot of practice change, but to keep it going for future generations, we need policy change, regulations, and systems change. In terms of policy and regulations, we know that those need to be supportive of what's happening in terms of best practices. And we know that written policies and regulations are more sustainable than voluntary programs. And there's work to be done at the state level to sustain all of these types of programs. We also need to take advantage of the growing acknowledgement of the link between health and education in order to ensure that healthy eating and physical activity are integrated into early care policy and regulations. And the focus on early care and education in this administration, in the Obama administration, is a great opportunity to include healthy eating and physical activity in initiatives. In terms of systems change, providers of childcare are our greatest assets for sustainability, and we need to ensure that they receive the supports they need, the education, the training, and the tools they need. And we also need to build on what already exists, rather than creating whole new systems. So providers already have systems of training and technical assistance. We need to actively engage all states. As I showed earlier, many states are doing work in this area, but to get the change that we need all states to be involved. We need to focus on integration of, as I said earlier, of the early care and education partners with the public health and healthcare experts to really increase the bandwidth and to break down silos. One of the things we learned early on is that it's not a lack of desire, it's really competing pressures. And so we need to focus on how we can create and incentivize and optimize opportunities for collaboration between early care and education and public health and child health generally. We need to balance spreading what works with ongoing innovation. There's a lot going on, but we need to really identify what works, and then we need to be intentional about spreading and scaling what works. Some of the things we've done in Delaware is, for example, this collaborative, where we've brought together groups of childcare centers in terms of a structured learning process. We have evidence and data that shows us that works, and so now we're intentionally, with the help of CDC, spreading that to other states. So that's what I mean by spread and scale. But we also need to balance that with innovation. There still needs to be innovation in areas. We need to figure out what are the effective accelerators and to use research to figure out, you know, what works and to also incubate innovation. In terms of filling research gaps, we need more well-designed studies to inform the implementation of effective strategies. There's not enough research in this area, so we need to know what works and then how to best spread them. And Mary Story and Diane Ward have done great work in this area where they've identified the research gaps, and that's the first place to look in terms of what kind of research we need. Finally, the other areas where I think we need attention in early care and education is in the area of physical activity, particularly for children between birth and age 2, in the area of family or home setting or kinship care, and also in the area of disparities. Lots of the data that Bill showed really speaks to the need to focus on disparities. In terms of a breakthrough action that I would recommend, I think we really need to strengthen the linkages between providers and families. Right now, it's an us versus them mentality, and actually, there's a shared goal of improving the health and wellness of children, and yet we haven't maximized the shared potential for influencing the necessary changes. We need to strengthen in the engagement of parents working with families. Some of the barriers are that that providers don't see parents as partners. And from the parents' perspective, parents are overwhelmed with their daily lives and they can't do it all. So this is an area I think if we focused on, we could get breakthroughs in early care and education. What we first need to do is develop a set of shared goals for parents and providers to work together. As I said earlier, there's a natural link there, and they all want what's best for kids. And then we need to really encourage their working together, and we really ultimately need to create a sense where the child care center is a family-friendly place to address issues in partnerships with parents. And so what I think it's going to take is to do some innovation in this area first, to develop some pilots, and then we need to, of course, research and evaluate those to figure out what works, and then develop an intentional method to spread and scale what works so that we can really focus in on this area and hopefully help to reverse the trends in this area with respect to obesity prevention. So I'll turn it over.
Thank you, Deb.
Sure.